Keith Lee, welcome and thank you for talking to us today. Tell me, what is InnoPage? Tell me about your business.
Okay. InnoPage is a mobile application development company. And what we do is we create our own apps and we also do other outsourcing jobs for other companies. Why we do it is because in Hong Kong, we have to maintain a positive cash flow. It's not like Silicon Valley. You can't just go out and raise a couple of million dollars and then just spend it all on R&D and hopefully the startup becomes successful. It's very difficult to do it in Hong Kong.
Why is that?
Because we don't yet have the ecosystem. We don't have enough investment company, venture capital companies that are interested in investing in IT sectors. Because as you know, in Hong Kong, the most risk-free business will be investing in real estate.
Mm. Yes. So how is InnoPage going about this?
All right. We spend 20% of our time to develop our own apps. So we take the profit from the consulting business and then to create our own apps. And we spin off our applications as a separate company and raise funds for that company and to be a real startup.
So first of all, what are you consulting? So InnoPage, what's the consulting side first?
InnoPage, the consulting business of InnoPage is to make apps for other companies. So there are companies that want to have mobile applications, but they don't plan to hire a team to do it in-house. So they have to outsource it to external apps development company. And we take those jobs and we charge a consulting fee to create apps for other people.
But what sort of apps are they? What type of apps?
All sorts of apps. We did a couple of government projects last year. So we have a correctional service, we have information services department, we have the tourism board, and we have consumer councils as our clients, and hospital authority. We did a couple of government projects, and also we have a couple of listed companies, clients like WeTech, like HMB, like so they're commercial corporate projects.
Okay, but you don't stop there. So then what do you do after that?
We take the profit from these consulting projects and create our own apps. So we have a couple of apps that we've done, like a dating app we've done. We have a stock portfolio management apps that we've done. And our latest app, which is a stock portfolio manager, will spin off as a separate company. So we have new investors, we have new partners, and we spin off that app and make it into a real startup.
Right, so you've got businesses within a business here.
Yes.
But the real startup is the investment.
Yes.
App. Okay. And yep. So what stage is that at the moment?
We have just finalized all the agreements, and then we will spin off the company in July this year. And we will make into a full-blown financial social network with the portfolio management aspect.
Okay, and so you'll be working with stockbrokers. Who's going to be giving the financial
advice? Our new partners is a news corporation. So we will have all the financial news feed. We will have real-time stock quote, and they are very established in the financial business side. Mm-hmm. And we are specialized in the apps development side.
Right. Okay, so that's a good partnership of the expertise there.
Yes.
And how long have you had InnoPage for? How many years? How
5 years.
Okay.
Yeah, we've been running InnoPage for 5 years. And so for most of the time, we have to maintain a positive cash flow. So we've done a lot of outsourcing work, and then but we don't stop there. It's just like Sony in the 50s. They were making radios. And then they take the profit from making radios into, you know, Walkman. So yes. Yeah, when they have a Walkman, they don't do any more radios.
Yes, yeah.
Interesting. Okay, so have you got a big team?
Our team is around 20 person. Okay. So around half of them are development staff.
And so in terms of the bottom line, how profitable is it so far? Because you're saying that you have mm-hmm. to maintain that positive cash flow. Mm-hmm. So how profitable is it?
I can only say we are making more profit, I mean more gross profit year after year.
Okay.
So from the very start, we have around seven staff. And then next year, we have 15. And then next year, we have 20. And we stay around 20 staff. And each year, we make more money than the previous year because the demand of making mobile apps has been growing very quickly, very rapidly.
But to make money off the mobile apps?
Yes, but consulting, but making money from the mobile apps is very difficult.
Yes.
We have apps that was featured by Apple on the App Store in the US.
Right.
So there are App Store around the world, there are, you know, App Store in Philippines, there are App Store in Singapore, in Hong Kong. But on the US App Store is a place that every apps developer wants to be on.
Yes.
And we were featured on the largest spot on the App Store.
Fantastic.
Yeah, and we had around 10,000 downloads per day. And but that doesn't guarantee a large income.
Right.
Yeah, because unless you are making games,
yes.
then you probably don't have a very 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 deep profit making formula.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
So it's very difficult to make money solely on apps.
Mm.
But for us, we have a stock portfolio manager which we charge a subscription. So each month they pay $2 to use our app, $2 to use our app. And when we accumulate a certain number of users, we will be, you know, cash flow positive. And we already done that, but I can't disclose the numbers because it's
sure.
Yeah, the NDA.
Yeah. So okay.
Yeah.
Where to? Are you already thinking about the next
yes.
venture? So you've got the finance app. Mm-hmm. Are you just going to concentrate on this, or you know, can you rest on your laurels, uh-huh. or mm-hmm. do you need to think about what else in
yeah.
the future?
Mm-hmm. Because the apps we created are the apps that we created were made in the 20% free time
right.
From our staff. So we have many ideas.
Mm-hmm.
So if we think this idea is interesting and we have we believe it will be successful, we just do it. If we find out it's not that successful, and we just stop that and then we go on to the next project.
Right.
Yeah. So we keep innovating,
right.
and we find the right product with the right product market fit, and then we develop it. But if it doesn't work, we go on to something else.
And that seems to be the theme that we're hearing today at
yeah.
this event. You know, don't be afraid of failure. As you said, innovate.
Yes,
it's part of the innovation.
Yeah, it's continuous innovation.
Great. Well, Keith Lee, thank you so much for sharing your story and all
thank
the best.
You.